Hi, my name is Erin, and I am a Science on Wheels educator here at Pacific Science Center. And today, I have a lesson for you about our respiratory systems. So we have some things you can try at home. We also have some real pig lungs with us today. So these are not human lungs, but they're about the same size and shape as our lungs. So we're gonna do some demonstrations with this. But first, let's talk about what are respiratory systems. So our respiratory system is the group of organs that allows us to breathe in and send oxygen around our body. So we begin with air coming in through our nose or mouth, and then it goes into our trachea. And your trachea is the tube in your throat that stays open and allows air to go through your lungs. And you can feel this. You take two fingers and gently rub it on the front of your throat here. You should feel sort of some hard bumps, and that is the cartilage that keeps your trachea nice and open. From your trachea, air goes into your chest and into two bronchial tubes that split into the left and right lung. So let's take a look here at these pig lungs to see a little bit more. As you can see, the left lung on this side is a little bit smaller because our heart sits right there in that pocket, and our right lung is a little bit bigger. Here you can see the bronchial tubes that brings air into the lungs. And when I squeeze these lungs, they're a little bit squishy and kind of spongy. And that's because they're filled with sacs of cells called alveoli. And the alveoli are the special cells that separate out oxygen and send that into our bloodstreams. So when we breathe in, our lungs inflate. And you can practice, I'm gonna inflate the lungs here, but you can try along at home. You can take a deep breath in, try to feel your lungs inflate, and then deflate as you exhale. So let's try, we'll take a big breath in. And our lungs fill with air and then deflate. Try again, breath in. And as you're doing that, you're breathing in oxygen, and then you're breathing out carbon dioxide. We'll try one more time. And exhale. So that's pretty cool and gives you an idea of what your lungs might look like inside your body. But now we have another demonstration where you can learn a little bit about what's going on in your body right now. So for this, we are going to test what's called nostril dominance. So your nostrils are those holes in your nose that you breathe in oxygen with. And at all times, one of your nostrils is breathing in a little bit more air than the other one. And you can test that at home. All you need is a small mirror or a piece of glass. And you're just gonna put this mirror right underneath your nose there and gently breathe in and breathe out. So let's give it a try. Breathe in. And as you look at the fog on this mirror, you should see that one nostril was a little bit bigger than the other one. So for me, my left nostril looked a little bit bigger than the right. We can try that again. So my left one had a little bit more fog than the right one. But if I try this again in a couple hours, that might switch because your nostrils go through what's called nasal cycling every 1 to 3 hours, where one nostril is a little bit stronger than the other one. And that is for a couple reasons. It keeps us healthy, it makes sure that both sides are working properly, and also gives us a more full sense of smell. So I hope you all learned a little bit more about your respiratory systems today. And now that you're all experts, you can teach your parents or your siblings, your dog, your uncle, whoever you're with, can teach them a little bit about the respiratory system, and we can all be healthy and smarter together. Thank you.